22 years ago, I was on a glacier in Greenland recovering this very airplane. It took us 14 weeks to recover it, 10 years to make it back into flyable condition, and now we've flown it over 500 hours, and less than 12 years ago we started flying. And what we're going to do today is just start the engines up so you can hear the Allison engine. You've heard all those noisy radios, and you're going to find that the tone of the P-38 is totally different than all those radios. But the engines are two Allison 1710 with Curtis electric propellers. They're very, very quiet. Each engine on this airplane is a 1,225 horsepower. So it's quite a fast airplane. Designed by Kelly Johnson, manufactured by Lockheed. It was the first plane to go 400 miles an hour. This plane is kind of plane, the P-38, was flown by America's leading ace, Richard Bomber. And that's about all I'm going to say today, except I really appreciate the fact of all the support, the people come over and talk with me while I was in front of the airplane. And just remember, we're doing all this for you and for our history.
Well, thank you, Bob. Really appreciate it. Last night, Bob put on a great presentation with a little PowerPoint and all. If you ever get a chance to see him anywhere talking about the aircraft, he does a great job. Has a great PowerPoint, great presentation, slideshow. But he, like you said, he's been involved with it for 22 years, I believe it is, from the finding of it on the glacier, under the glacier, actually, to the recovery and restorations. The Allison engines he was talking about was a V12 liquid cooled, just a really special airplane. Yeah, Scott is our media guy and PR guy and everything, just wanted me to talk about the propellers. One of the things they found with the P-38 at the very beginning. Most aircraft, the propellers turn inboard when you have a twin. The reason for that is so you don't have the torque. If you lose an engine, then the engines are, most of the torque is the P-factor, they call it, the propellers. Torque from the propellers is inboard, so it's not as drastic. But they found that they had a lot of problems with the across the tail, with the power going across the tail, so these are actually going the opposite direction, so the major torque is on the outside. Well, we talk about critical engines on some aircraft that when they turn the same way, the one engine it's fine because the torque's not as much as the other one. But this one, they're both critical because they're both providing a lot of torque outboard. So if you lose either one of them, you've got a handful. Got to really work it hard. A lot of rudder, a lot of rolling into the good engine. And it's not as easy as it is with most other aircraft. Here you go, he's going to restart it.
engines both have mechanical driven superchargers. But when you fly these, you constantly have, you change the fuel ratio mixture due to the air? Or?
No, it's automatic. Okay. You put an auto rich, auto lean, and go from there. High power settings, like before I just did the mag check, I come up with auto rich.
Put in brake under, right?
Oh, yeah.